I just bought this truck. It's a 1990 L8000. Has a 270 horsepower Brazilian diesel. Definitely not a powerhouse, but it is a good running engine. They use them in farm tractors and stuff like that, so they're meant to be ran, but definitely not a powerhouse. But definitely needs some work here. You know, I mean, this isn't in that bad of shape. The fenders are the biggest problem, but yeah, 46,000 rears, Henderson suspension. And like I said, this truck's in really nice shape for a 1990. Does have all brand new snow tires on it, which I might put on the International. Just, you know, due to just having this as an extra truck, can't really see, you know, having I mean, those tires are decent on that. That truck runs like every day. This one won't, so I might rob those. But yeah, I mean, look, the stickers are still here, all original stickers. The hoist is mint. That's kind of why I bought this truck. But you know, definitely need some work on the hydraulic tank, but not rotted out. And has a 20-foot hoist. This goes our tower. This goes up 20 feet with a tarper in there. But definitely old. I mean, you know, you got to play with the spring to get it to work. But I mean, the cab, besides that, I mean, it's actually not bad at all. Tanks aren't rotted out, cab's not rotted. Good front tires. This truck actually has an exterior pump, which is not the fastest, but it does work good. And if you left the PTO on by accident, it wouldn't hurt this pump. Because they can run, they are like a live pump technically. This one does have a switch to shut it off, but my front end load truck has the same one, and that's always live, so I don't think you can really hurt that pump. But yeah, this truck does have all brand new brakes, brand new clutch, and it does only have 130,000 miles on the motor, and I think 200 and something on the truck. So the guy that I bought it from right here, I knew him personally, and he did put the motor in it. Stickers off the door. But finally Napa started selling, instead of the 3M, they're selling these. I forget what the company, I just threw the package out, but these are $17.99 and the 3Ms are $55. So for $18. And I've used the rubber wheels on aluminum. I used them on my Peterbilt. I used them on all kinds of different things. They've never taken paint off. Obviously this paint was messed up from whoever took the previous sticker off, which if they used a rubber wheel, that this would have never happened.
don't.
All right, check it out. It's nice. All right. So just a little bit cleaning up. Up in there. Anybody home in there? Anybody home?
That's the ground wire right there. That's got to get fixed.
That was supposed to do that. Moss and I are on lunch break here.
Let's see. Get that stuff off there for you, Moss. I think you're supposed to have onion. Ready?
Mmm. That good, buddy? All right, let's take a look here. So this is going like this. This needs to go like this. So I have something to bolt that too. So I don't think it's really gonna affect anything to have it on top because there's nothing here. All I need to do is be able to get out these two bolts and weld this on. I guess I should cut this up. Let me keep that. This side's actually a better cut. Go like that. Yeah. professional. So I'll probably do a weld in here. I mean, I could do one there. I didn't clean that up. This isn't going anywhere. Like, you could jump up and down on this thing. It's not gonna break. Just like this. Check this out.
Nice new fenders.
Nice and clean looking. Nice and level. Now we gotta get up in here. Up in here, this is where I was adjusting it before. So you can slide this up or down depending on how you want it or whatnot. right, but you might want to be safer than this. You should really buy a cage. Even though these aren't split, I don't even want to jinx myself. Back up. So even though these aren't split rims, if the tire blows out, say the sidewall blows out, this thing can fly a million miles an hour. If you're that way, that way, whatever. So I'll probably put like 50, 60 pounds, and then once it's bolted on the truck, I'll just fill all the tires. That way, if the tire, the sidewall blows out because the tire wasn't, because they're used tires, at least that, it would be loud, scary, but the rim can't fly anywhere because it's bolted to the truck. So it'll just be really loud and blow out, but, you know, that should be in a cage right now. So I just stand back here and let it fill up. We're above full, but that should be perfect.
I don't know if you're gonna see it up there. 5, right and crooked. Gallons.
Got really good pressure now. Thank you. there.
Best year for that.
All right, that looks a lot better. Get some white paint, touch that up, but this thing, for a 1990, it's probably the cleanest one around. But got these nice fenders on now. That's all nice looking. And the back end really cleaned up nice, rather than having all that rust on there. So that looks good. Fenders on this side. So truck's been sitting a while, so you see all the green stuff coming off, but really looks a lot better now, you know. So only thing left to do now is take it for a ride.